We have a band that's going to rock and roll today for us,
yeah,
man.
Yeah.
Nice. And we're back with the O&A show. 877-692-1027 if you're in the New York area and you want to get a hold of us. In studio today, a bunch of our pals. Cowbell Bill.
Yo.
Old Dirtay.
Yeah.
Jim Norton. And a band that's going to rock your socks off in a few minutes.
Yeah, open that door. They're like...
Sound check.
Yeah, they're doing a sound check.
As loud as F out there.
The building's going to hate us. Also, the Playboy's out with Jerry from Survivor 2.
Yo, where's the B-Warrior?
Wait, you can't find her? Yeah, that always sucks about Playboy. You try to find something in there, you can never find it.
Yo, this body been airbrushed, kid.
Yeah,
I'm not digging that.
I'm not feeling that.
Still don't cut it.
You don't like the breasts?
Nah, look at those things, OD.
You can hang your coat off those nips.
Oh, she got the big, gnarly, pinky tip nip things going.
That's all right, though. You guys are out of your minds.
What's the problem?
Very like? Solid.
Right?
No. Right, you know something?
Jim, I'm not taking your word. I've seen what you go after.
Jim, I'm not denying the fact you'd throw that down after a night hanging out at a bar or something like that. Yeah, and that would be a nice catch. But we're talking Playboy.
It's all right.
In Swank, she would be a killer.
She'd be a hit.
Oh, yeah.
But, you know, Playboy, you're now putting yourself against... Look at the centerfold, OD. Turn to the centerfold. Now you tell me something.
There you go.
Yeah.
That's
Playboy.
That's
Playboy.
Right. Oh, no, Don. I see.
You got to put her in a magazine where the next shot is a disgusting hair-filled cave shot. You know what I mean? One of those big, stretchy pictures.
I can't get past the teeth thing. They look all grinded down and stuff.
What, hers?
Yeah, something's going on.
You're looking at her teeth. I got to be honest, I didn't notice her teeth. I
noticed it during the show.
What's up with her toothuses, yo?
Hey,
what's
up? Kimmy.
Hey.
Our pal is on the line, Kimmy from Survivor.
What's going on?
Kimmy, you could have done a much better job in Playboy. Why didn't you go for it?
We've seen you naked.
I know you have, but if you look at her boobs in Playboy, and you guys have seen my boobs, her boobs look like as big as mine, you know?
Yeah, but they're not quite as perky.
Yeah, she's, I don't know. I mean, it looks good. I mean, it's a very simple kind of spread. I mean, I think, like, the background is kind of boring, but she looks good against the blue.
She's all right. Jim, you've seen both girls naked now. Who has the hotter body, Kimmy from Survivor or Jerry?
Kimmy definitely has the hotter body, but I like Jerry better because I still think I have a shot at banging Jerry.
Oh, you totally turned
Kimmy
off?
Definitely hotter. No, she's definitely hotter.
Kimmy, where you been? Why do you say you're going to come down and then you don't show up?
Well, you know what it was? My little niece had some little problems.
My little niece had
but she's
a problem.
Okay. We found out.
She got what?
What happened to her?
She was having, like, these really bad headaches and everything, and she had to, like, go have an MRI and some CAT scans and everything, but it turns out that she's okay. My sister just called me. But, you know, she's four, so.
No, I'm glad she's doing okay.
Yeah, but.
And that wasn't me laughing this time.
And I'll take responsibility for that. I thought she was 18.
She's almost old enough for you. She's four.
You cure that by smashing their head on the corner of a porcelain sink.
I'm going to come in like a week or so because I did a photo shoot for Edge magazine where it's a little bit, you know, I kept my clothes on, but it's a little bit racy and fun and playful.
Racy, yeah, baby.
Kimmy, you weren't even approached by Playboy?
Playboy had talked to us through CBS, and yes, I was one of the people that they talked to.
So why didn't you take it off?
We all know you're not shy.
honestly, I think that the money that they were coming out with, I'd like to do something more serious.
How much they offer?
They were starting in the area of about $300,000, and that's really not, like, a lot of money.
Yeah, you need a pimp to work that.
Exactly. I mean, even if they were doing, like, $400,000 or so, I mean, after taxes and everything, it's really not that much money.
Take it and run. What are you doing?
Yeah.
What did the Edge thing give you? Edge magazine.
A good time, baby.
And no money?
We haven't even heard of The Edge.
Yeah. I know. It's a new magazine. It's only been out a couple months.
Did they give you
$200,000? I did it in Vegas, so I went out to Vegas.
Did they give you $200,000?
No, but I kept my clothes on.
Yeah, but what's the deal? Who cares?
Kimmy, you have morals all of a sudden?
No. You know what? It's because I want to do something, you know, hosting a wildlife or environmental show or something. So, for me, if I did Playboy, I have to wait a couple years until I'm really, really worth something, and then I can ask for $1 million.
You know, Jerry is pretty desperate.
She wants she really is. She wants to be famous so effing bad. And then she's like, all right, I'll go for the Playboy thing right away.
What do you want? What kind of nature show you want to do? Like the crocodile hunter?
Yeah, I want to be out in the dingo. No, I'd really, I mean, that's what I went to school for and everything. And I want to do something with wildlife or environmental documentaries.
All right, we'll get you in a magazine where you can do a pig or something. No? It's not the kind of wildlife thing you want to do?
Right, well, PETA asked me.
Have you with a pony.
PETA asked me to do a like
remember that clip?
Campaign with a pig.
Yeah. We'll have you do the new horse gag video.
Oh, no.
who hasn't downloaded the horse gag video? And right at the point where she goes, just laughed their yam bags off.
It's like a spit take from a vaudeville comedy.
Kimmy, what'd you say about PETA?
Oh, PETA wanted me to pose with a pig for a Go Vegetarian campaign.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. That's wow, that's just as big as being in Playboy.
Yeah, you're on your way to the top, baby.
No, but I think that
moves.
When you guys see the pictures that I did in Edge magazine, you guys will actually like them.
Can we spank to them, you think? Are they spank-worthy?
I think they're spankable. Some of them are definitely spankable because it was so funny because I was in Vegas when we did the photo shoot, and in some of the shots I'm wearing lingerie, and we were just running around Vegas like jumping out of the car having the pictures taken and then like jumping back in the car because you're not supposed to do like, you know, commercial photography in Vegas.
What type of shenanigans were going on there?
All kinds of no good nonsense.
You piped down over there, Norton. You just piped down.
Oh boy, oh boy.
For the love of Eve.
Oh gosh.
What do you think you're doing over there?
But it was so funny because I was wearing like these big huge like F me pumps.
Yeah.
And little shorts.
Is that big mouth of yours nice and open?
Oh, yeah, and a couple of them, they're open.
That's good. I like when you open that up.
Oh, yeah.
But just, like, walking through the casinos, like, we were walking through Paris and the Bellagio and stuff, and I had, like, four or five guys with me, and I had, like, my hair all done. I had, like, really, like, big makeup on. You guys know I don't, like, wear tons of makeup. And I was just, like, walking around, and everybody's head was turning, like, oh, my God, who is this? She's a sinner. It's like people were taking their small children out of the hotel. Don't look at
her.
In
Vegas?
In Vegas. They're used to seeing that crap.
Yeah.
But not like, just, like, through the casino.
Did you have sexual intercourse with anybody that night?
No, I did not.
Jesus. Why not?
When was the last time you had sex, Kimmy?
Didn't know.
What do you think? What time is it? A couple hours ago.
Really?
What celebrity's life did you ruin this time?
Be nice to me.
Any celebrities recently hitting on you?
Oh, can I tell you a funny story?
Absolutely.
You know who I actually ran into the other last week twice?
Oh. Kevin James?
Kevin James.
What did he say?
You know, nothing. We just kind of like looked at each other. No, but it was funny because one night he was up at Wall Street. And it was just really funny because we ended up just like talking to each other, and I'm like, I didn't tell everybody that we were doing it.
Oh, what did he say?
He's like.
Did he believe you?
Yeah. I think that he was a little surprised.
Kimmy has never officially admitted that she did Kevin James.
I will admit that she did Kevin James.
But I'm
based on all the facts, Kimmy.
What?
Did you do Kevin James?
Yeah.
Got it.
Right?
Yeah, like, just admit it.
Yeah, just press
it. I did not do Kevin James.
Oh, now she's totally backing down.
You couldn't say that the whole day you were here. You couldn't say that, Kimmy.
You fess up to it, or we'll tell the other one.
No, you will not.
Well, then you fess up to Kevin.
Okay,
tell the
fine.
Truth.
I banged Kevin. You cannot go ruin people's lives.
Yeah, we can.
All right, Kevin. It's always funny.
You guys are so bad. Don't you have something new to torture me with, like some new whipped cream?
Trail of chopped meat through this show. It's just behind us.
Hey, did you give Kevin James the hepatitis Slurpee?
Oh, my God.
That's my new favorite Jim Norton saying. The hepatitis Slurpee.
He'd have to give it to her.
God, you guys are so bad. But no, I'm going to come down there bringing like my pictures and everything.
All right.
Yeah,
we would love
to
see you and your pictures.
Yeah, and I want to come down on a Friday because I want to give a big FU Friday to Saturn of Smithtown, those bunch of rejects.
No, we extended the whole FU thing all week, so.
Oh, good. Well, then we can FU Saturn of Smithtown.
What do they do? Deny you?
You know what? They're just idiots. Like, they had some guy totally rip me off in my car. Like, they went and they took my car in December, telling me that I needed, like, a whole new motor in the side of my door. Went and I bought the motor. It turns out that's not what I needed. I needed a switch.
When you're telling these little stories, here's a good idea. Have a point. It makes it so much more interesting for the listener.
You guys are horrible.
So you were telling a fascinating story about a switch?
Fascinating story.
You know what, Kimmy? One time I was driving and I was trying to get through a light, right? And this guy is going really slow, and I'm like, "Are you going to hurry up? You understand here?"
Yeah, I'm sorry, Jim. Jim, I'll make it more racy and exciting for you. Let's think of something new we can cover my body in.
Mm.
Wow, Jim, you hit that, dude.
Yeah, we'll throw more stuff on you.
Yeah, we got to play some more. We got to play. Right.
Kimmy, I would rather see you in Playboy than Jerry.
Yep.
Yeah,
without a doubt.
See, because you guys know me now, but it wasn't always like that. Remember back in the day before you even knew me?
No, we just said that you sounded really annoying, and that opinion hasn't changed. We think you're really hot. Well, we just like you now.
First impressions always last.
I mean, why couldn't they get Colleen in the Playboy?
Yeah, that's what
or
we
Amber.
Say.
Jerry.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know, but I mean, I think that Jerry's eyes look amazing with the background, and her body's cute.
Eyes.
So.
Nobody cares about her eyes.
Yeah, ain't saying it.
Ain't cutting it.
You know what, Jerry would be great in Playboy? Blair's cousin?
Big gnarly, crusty nips.
From the Facts of Life?
Yeah.
Oh,
that would rock. In the wheelchair or thrown out onto the floor naked?
Naked, old palsy box.
Cousin Jerry,
like
that's
Davis's
right.
Face.
Didn't the magazine, I think it was Hustler, do a centerfold with a paraplegic? Remember? And she was laying out on the bed, and they had to pose her legs.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
How great is that?
Hey, yeah. we could do that on our show if you'd like. You want to do paraplegic
posing?
Like a lingerie?
Centerfold
show thing?
Why not?
How will you know if they're really paraplegic, though?
You take a bite out of their thigh, and if they scream, they're out.
Oh, my God. There's always something new and interesting and exciting that we could do.
All right, Kimmy, come in and see us soon, all right?
All right, I'll see you guys soon.
All right, there she goes.
Bye.
Kimmy from Survivor fame.
Ciao, baby.
Yo, no, and you hit that, dude? No, but she was naked in front of me, and it was really nice.
We've all seen her naked. She's unbelievable.
She was completely naked.
Look, she had whipped cream on her. Sounds like we're bitching about Jerry's body. Of course she has a pretty nice body and stuff, but I'm telling you right now, Kimmy's body is unbelievable compared to that.
Oh, dude, she had whipped cream all in every crevice.
Yeah.
And then she went into the bathroom to clean off, and Norton goes in there and took the paper towels, damn paper towels, and started wiping out of every nook and cranny of her body.
She was bending over, and I'm squatting behind her 3 inches in front of my face.
Yep.
I was so happy.
Oh. Right there, ground zero.
Really sexy. Yeah,
it was
really
nice. All right, we have to take a break. Anthony, after the break, we're coming back with Clutch. We're
nice.
So excited today. They're going to jam a couple songs for us. We've been digging that one song, Careful With That Mic. You know,
Yeah.
They're here to hang with us today, so we'll talk to them in just a few.
You guys have redefined debauchery.
It's like a vaudeville show on acid.
Opie. Anthony. Opie and Anthony. 1027 WNEW.
We're back with the Opie and Anthony show. Jim Norton in the studio, Old Dirty floating around here. And Clutch has made their way into the studio, Anthony.
Yeah.
We are very psyched these guys are here. But I have a problem right off the bat, though, with Neil, the singer.
I can't imagine what it would be.
Dude, you dumped in our bathroom, man. Oh, who else smells that grass?
I blew the spot in your bathroom. I did.
It's the crunch-free bathroom because there's no vent or no windows.
But you do have eyewash in there.
Thank God, yeah, for the emergency dump.
Here's audio of Neil taking a dump.
One of those. One of those that leaves your shirt looking like you rode through a mud puddle on your 10-speed.
I was walking out there. I think that's the guy that's on the microphone that just walked in there after me.
I walked in right after you. I'm like, oh.
Yeah, we usually keep that a crunch-free bathroom because there's no ventilation.
We got to put the sign up because it's so funny. The only people that will crunch in there is like guests of the show because no one else wants the abuse.
Well, I just want to leave you something to remember us by.
That's yeah, that's good. That works.
I got to go to Steve. He's been holding for a long time. He's from Philly. Steve, what's up?
Yeah, what's going on, O&A?
Hey.
Yeah, I'm just glad to hear you guys got a really good band like Clutch on the radio.
Yeah, they're playing Irving Plaza here in New York on Wednesday.
Yeah, I want to see him in Lancaster on August 6th, Lancaster, Pennsylvania, but the Chameleon.
Right on.
So, stoked. Heard you play him that first time when you put them on, was it Careful with the Mic? I heard you playing it. I couldn't believe it. Mm-hmm. I was like, yes, Clutch on the Radio. That's what I'm talking about.
We've been
fan for like 5 years.
Cool. We got a question for them? They're right here. Hear that?
Neil, what are you talking about, man? You're nuts.
In general?
Yeah.
Just whatever comes to mind.
It's
great. Whatever's entertaining.
Trying to figure out what who are you talking about Astropithecus and Cray?
Astropithecus, that's a kind of monkey. Like Missing Link.
Uh-huh.
Cray's a computer. Supercomputer, one of the first ones, I believe.
Wow. What am I talking about specifically?
Oh, nothing. It was just just something, a list of absurd rhymes to entertain my bandmates. And, didn't direct it towards anybody, and that's the God's honest truth.
Cool. And, Jean-Paul, you're ridiculous on the drums. Love it.
Thank you, sir.
I play drums myself. And...
All right, Steve.
Thanks, man.
Thanks. They're gonna play for us in a little bit here, so.
I'll be listening.
All right.
Cool.
You guys got together in high school 10 years ago?
Yeah. This August, August 10th? Yeah, it'll be 10 years since our first show.
You remember the first song you played for everyone?
I don't know.
Like in public?
I remember the first show, but I don't remember the first song. You know what it was?
It might have been Arcadia.
Yeah, we have a song called Arcadia that was on one of our 7-inches.
Right. What was the first performance you guys did?
As Clutch was in Fort Reno, Washington, D.C.
But was there, I don't know. I want to ask, was it a talent show? I mean, you know what I mean?
What was it? It was just an outdoor...
Free festival.
Free, yeah.
Yeah?
They have them every week in D.C.
Uh-huh.
Just a bunch of people laying around in the grass.
Jamming.
Yeah, feeling it.
Hanging. Wait, this girl has a great question for Neil. Leslie, what's up?
Hi, I just want to ask Neil how I could get his attention on a show. It was at his last show and I was trying to get his attention. I don't know how to do it.
Take a dump in the bathroom.
No! I want to get good attention, not bad attention.
Man, you should smell his dump, Leslie. We all do.
I don't want to do that. I just want to hang out with him after a show.
Neil?
After the
comment?
Show.
Oh, well.
How do I get your attention?
Flares.
Can do that. Throw something at him. No, don't do that.
Are you a good-looking lady there, Leslie?
Yeah, I'm pretty good-looking.
Yeah?
I was just at your Tradewind show the other day.
Did you have a good time there?
Yeah, I had a good time. Yes. I had a real good time.
Were you trying to get backstage or anything?
Not really. I didn't know who to ask. I was just trying to look at you through that little window.
You guys playing that angle with the girls? Is it easy for you guys? Yeah, go ahead.
I'll play that angle.
I'm a married man. So
there you go.
I knew there was something going on with Neil. He's like,
all right.
You want to know a good way, Leslie? Leslie.
Yep. Definitely. Definitely a good way. Are you going to the show on the first, Jim?
Hey, Leslie, are you a goer, though?
I'm going to try to go, yeah.
No, are you a goer?
Oh, am I a goer? Yeah, absolutely.
You'll go the distance, right?
Absolutely.
There you go.
For Clutch, definitely.
Look at that.
Neil, does this bother you at all? You're married, and, now you got the band, it's happening, and these girls want you, and...
And I've been listening for a long time, too.
Does it bother me?
Yeah, you know.
It doesn't bother me.
He's a little nervous.
No? Doesn't bother you, though?
No, I'm just kind
right, well,
of shaking
I'll
after the dump I took.
Yeah. I'll see you guys at the show at Irving Plaza.
Yeah, that's Wednesday.
Yep.
All right, Leslie, thank you.
All right, take care. Bye-bye.
All right.
Bye.
We got Kristen from Philadelphia wants to say hi. Kristen, what's going on?
Hey, how you guys doing?
Pretty good. We're hanging with Clutch.
I can tell. It's about time. God, I've been waiting to hear Clutch on the radio for so long.
A lot of girls like you guys, huh? Get a lot of girls at the show?
More and more.
Yeah.
And, 5-10 years ago, it was just strictly a...
bunch of dudes, right?
Like a frat party, basically.
Not anymore.
Like one of our roast shows.
What do you like about the band, Kristen?
Oh, good God. I have to name one thing?
Oh, just, in general.
Jesus. Well, aside from the...
I mean, they look just like NSYNC.
Oh, man. That has nothing to do with it. The fact that it takes intelligence to be able to enjoy Clutch songs.
Look at that. Look at that.
Do you guys ever visit the Pro Rock Board?
Say that again, Kristen.
I'm sorry. I was asking the band, do you guys ever visit the Pro Rock Board?
Occasionally.
Occasionally?
Sometimes it's a little disturbing. There's a lot of nutheads on that message board that like to lie, but it's flattering. They're going to lie about us. I mean, they could not be lying at all.
What's the biggest lie you've read about you? He's laughing. He doesn't want to say.
You want to field that?
Whoa, really? That bad?
Actually, they really don't lie about us for some reason. I wish they would.
You don't think they lie?
About us personally? No, about themselves, yeah.
You and the message board. What, you actually feel bad about stuff you read on message boards?
No, not at all.
No?
Never.
Oh, okay. Like, because that's just kind of comes with the territory now, you know?
You got to take it with a grain of salt.
Yeah.
Ed, what's up?
Hey, what's going on, guys?
Hey.
I've been diehard Clutch fan since, like, 95. You know, I want to say thank God for getting him on the radio.
Cool.
I'm going to the Irving Plaza show. I went to Trade Winds a couple days ago. I just want to say, Neil, you guys, man, I remember seeing Marilyn Manson. You guys opening up for Marilyn Manson, and then I left him, started going with you guys. You guys are great.
Right on.
Any way I can get to meet you guys on Wednesday?
Yeah, sure.
Just got a flush, too?
No, you can just strangle Leslie when she's done.
I'll push her aside and take the wheel.
All right, Ed, hold on, all right?
Oh, beauty. Right, thanks, cool. Man.
Well, you guys want to rock or what?
Yeah.
Hell yeah.
They are set up outside the studio, and it's going to get nice and loud, eh?
Cool.
All right, let's head outside.
Head out.
Yeah, why not?
Take their positions. And we'll rock. Wow, a lot of people out there now.
It's like 30, 40 people outside of the studio.
Hanging. Waiting for Clutch. Can they start quick? Is it one of those bands that can pop on, or they got to...
I think they're all set, ready to go. Hey, guys. Neil.
This is going to be loud.
Oh, all right. Well, just tell them to go when they're ready.
Hello?
It's going to be loud. Hey.
So we,
Neil, whenever you're ready, we're here.
Whenever we're ready, huh?
Yeah, this is Clutch, man. Check them out. Right.
You guys ready? Scholastic aptitude test. Did you know the answer? Did you guess? You and I can expect your fans and act our Irvin to check your sound scan. What's the matter for you? How can I monitor please after you're shaking your tie vocabulary? Stars like garbage cats meant to be taken on a weekly basis. As your first rank, you've been stage suspended animation. You look like stuff alone. It's an astrophysicist. Me crit, you advocates. But enough about you. Let's talk about me and I'll single-handedly get the fine science of radio astronomy. Make a number of prize winners. First hypnosis of reality. Over I digress. You always win the sorry. I always win the chess. Go get some Percocets. Come on with that Mike Weezy. Do you really think it's that easy? This is really good ice cream. You want some of it? Oh, my bad. I didn't know you're lactose intolerant. Makes you pass gas, rides all the girls away. Only friends you keep are those you pay. Always ready for the wax snack attack. Carry sandwiches around the straight and style. Chance for a backpack. Got the gadget, QJ bomb. Control your mind. Make you jump in a pond. Go quack, quack. Flap your arms. You're confused, but completely unharmed. Ha, 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 ha. I'm rather intense, I'm ashamed of it that I'm a fool by the seductions of violence. People walk around with ugly aura, sometimes even tempted to seek advice of Dr. Laura. But I go run, take a deep breath and count to ten. Ain't gonna let it get under my skin. Take a deep breath and count to ten. Think of all the nice places that I've been. Like back when I was rich and pissed against the Pelagos. I was too easy, mysteries by a wise and philosoph. Learn the finding rhythm of celestial time. Don't want to come, get it done, finish the rhyme. Ha ha ha! you go.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Clutch live in the studio, Anthony. Careful with
nice.
That mic.
Are you ready for another one? You're going to do a...
Yeah, we can do another one.
For a while, what?
Yeah, let's do another one, man.
All right.
We got Clutch playing Irving Plaza here in New York on Wednesday night.
Highly Irving recommend. Plaza.
Highly recommend you go check out the
Where's
the guys.
My money?
All right, Neil.
So we're going to tune our guitars up real quick, and we're going to do a song called Immortal that we wrote with Leslie West.
Cool. Aha. Leslie West from Mountain.
Thank the very you. Same.
Yes. I'd add that in like a real DJ. Leslie West from Mountain.
From Mountain. You might remember Leslie West from Mountain.
Right. You guys ready?
Yeah, let's go.
It's Clutch.
Clutch Immortal. On the Opie and Anthony Show. Jay Moore in the studio.
Jay Moore.
The whole party around here.
I got to tell you, that's a hit. I already am singing along to it.
Ain't that good?
That guy rocks.
That's Neil and the gang from Clutch. They're playing Irving Plaza this Wednesday here
that's
in New York
City. That's Clutch.
Hey, right.
They are Clutch. I didn't even hear the vocals when I first came in. I was just tripping out on like the bass line and the drums.
No, that's why you got to come in here to hear it.
Yeah, it was cool.
Out there, you can't hear the vocals.
But it's still cool. They're rocking.
Yeah, they're rocking big time. Terry, what's going on?
Hey, those guys rock.
Yeah, we like the Clutch.
They've been out for 10 years. How many albums they got out?
That's a good question. I don't even know.
Which would be the best one to pick up?
Thank you, Terry.
All right.
Bye. Oh, we're getting an email here from Diane. She says, what are you guys doing up there? You're totally rocking our offices. We're on the 8th floor. Who's playing up there? Someone on the floor down below. Checking in, Diane.
Diane, you should have came up.
Yeah. Imagine what that sounds like, though, on the 8th floor. It's like...
what the hell is going on? Is this an office building? Like, is, they don't realize maybe it's a radio station up here. You're working at your office.
No, they're downstairs selling Amway. Yeah. The guy's like, and I understand we have a few diamond distributors in the audience. Boom. I'm immortal. All right.
I just want to tell you about the program.
You know, we also just figured out that we have some problems with our little syndication thing.
Yeah.
Because we're on like a 10,000-watt AM in San Francisco.
Amplitude modulation.
Can you imagine how that sounded out there in San Francisco, clutch jamming on the AM dial?
Like the old days.
My Lord.
Remember the old days of AM radio? Come on. Music radio.